Well, Celltrion, now one of South Korea's most well-known pharmaceutical companies, has successfully entered the U.S. market. Now, it received a FDA stamp of approval for its latest drug. So just how significant is this leap for the Korean biohealth industry? Unshinn explains.
Last Wednesday, Korean pharmaceutical firm Celltrion received the U.S. Food and Drug Administration approval for sale. South Korea's very first biosimilar successfully entering the U.S. market is significant for many reasons. One of the most important being that as of 2010, the U.S. accounted for about 46% of the global biologics market, according to Forbes Magazine. The company's biosimilar Remsima, developed to treat patients with autoimmune diseases, is expected to bring in $2 billion annually from the American market alone. So what exactly are the advantages of biosimilars compared to other biologics and chemical drugs that the mass market has been familiar with so far, and how are they so marketable? It's widely known that due to the complicated process of development, biologics cost more to produce than chemical drugs. But what makes biosimilars so appealing is that they could be as inexpensive as common medicines.
The biggest advantage of biosimilars are its affordability, and along with that, though it's called biosimilar because it's supposed to be almost identical to the pre-existing medications, it's safe to expect they are just as effective as the originals.
In a way, biosimilars are generics of biologics in terms of affordability, and South Korea is trying to catch up with the global market and potentially get ahead.
The country's getting closer, step by step, to becoming a biohealth industry giant. The country's biotechnology is showing speedy development.
Unshinn, Arirang News.